Welcome to the second part of this simulation. In this part, I will be talking about the steam cycle, which is this one. The heat generated from this combustion cycle will be used for the production of steam in this boiler. So let's move to the simulation of Aspen Plus. So click new and create a blank simulation. Okay, so here is water. Since in the steam cycle we have only one component, which is steam. That's okay. Now move to the method. Click next. Go to the method. Here you need to choose the method according to your working environment. Here I will be using this one, IAPWS95, which is used for the steam, and it contains all the thermodynamic properties of steam. So choose this one, and if it is not mentioned in your assignment or in a question, then you have to know which one to choose. And one more thing I just want to explain here, this, if you just keep your cursor here, you will be able to understand like what this method is about. So just put your cursor here and then read this what this method will be. Like this one, this is Rayleigh's long equation, instead with Henry's law, these sort of things you can understand from here. Okay, so now move forward. Okay, so table generation is completed. That means we can move to the simulation part now. From here, firstly, I will choose a pump. Okay, so then boiler. This is this one. Boiler and turbine. Go to pressure cooler. Go to turbine. Okay, so now take the streams. This one outlet. This one short. Okay, so just move the remote, rotate this one. Keep horizontal. Okay, so just click right click and reconnect. That means you go to the destination here. Okay, so material, click here, connect this one, this one. Okay, so this is open loop cycle. So if I want to make closed loop, then you put a condenser here, similar using this one, and then connect with this one, then it will be a closed cycle. So, but I'm not going to that closed cycle to make it simple. Alright, so now put your input here. Let's say the cold water temperature is 20 degrees centigrade, pressure is 1 bar, and flow rate, mass flow rate is 100 kg per hour. Next, so block B1, let's come from the flow sheet, it will be easier for you to understand. Block B1 means pump, and click here. So this pump, let's make the discharge pressure 20 bar, efficient and pump efficiency is less than 0.9. This is what I mean. And this is low pressure high pressure water. This is what I mean, this is high pressure water. You can go to the boiler. Boiler, and this is high pressure steam. And this is turbine. And this is the low pressure steam after discharging from the turbine. Okay, so I have given the input for this one, as well. So now let's move to the boiler. Let us, this is isobaric process between boiler and pump. So make the pressure 20. And this thing you need to understand, like what temperature you're going to put here. So based on the previous simulation, we saw the temperature was around 1800 degrees centigrade, right? So that temperature we will be using in the boiler. So so based on your design, you use the temperature here, or alternatively you can use the heat duty. Heat duty, like how much the kilowatt of energy you want to put for the production of steam in the boiler. So that is based on your combustion reactor energy, which you will be getting in the product side of your reactor. So I'm just keeping it simple, like in the temperature, let's make it 1000 degrees centigrade. And the pressure, 20 bar. And temperature. So pressure is 20 bar and the temperature is 1000 degrees centigrade. Okay, so one thing you need to be very careful about this one, vapor liquid. It should be vapor. Vapor only from the boiler. Let's move. Okay, so now this block is about turbine. Okay, so I will again come from the flow sheet. This will be easier for you to understand. So let's move to the turbine now. So this is turbine. So make it, so yeah, this is again based on your design, like which one you want to use, and also based on your problem descriptions. So if I, if it is said that if you have, to use isentropic, use isentropic, and of course the isentropic divisions will be given. So let's say it's 0.9. Okay, and this subspecial you need to choose this subspecial. I'm putting, let's say, 5 bar. And one thing you need to be careful here as well. So make sure the pressure you are putting in the turbine outlet is, of course, the lower than the pressure which is the input pressure of the turbine. Which is usually happens in the turbine, right? Okay. So now, again, have a look. So we have given the input for this one, and this one as well. So now, I'm going to put here. Another thing you need to understand, or you need to know, there are three streams in Aspen Plus. One is material, secondary heat, and work. So you can use these streams based on your box and design. For example, here, our idea is to get the work, right? So I'm putting the work stream here so that I can understand how much the work I have. So now, just to run the simulation, all done. So simulation is done. So another thing I'm showing you, in the modify option, you will have the option to choose this option, temperature, pressure, this sort of things, and this will come here, and it's easy for you to understand what the temperature, what the pressure, and what other parameters you have in different sections. All right, so just moving this a bit forward. From here, you see in the turbine, okay, go to the results. Result is available, so go to the results. Lastly, you can choose this way. Result summary. Okay, click here. Result stream. Now, from here, you see, I will go from water in, and then low pressure, high pressure water, then low pressure steam, and high pressure steam, and then low pressure steam. Sequence. So one by one. So you can see the temperature here. So initially you had temperature of 20 degrees centigrade, and then in the vapor phase, which is going to be the temperature in the pressure, temperature in the turbine, which is 729. And you can see the exit temperature of the low pressure steam as well. So yeah, so it's 1000 degree steam is going to go in the turbine, and after shaft work, it's 729 degrees centigrade. The mass flow, of course, it will be same for the system, and also based on the pressure you have put in the turbine, you will get it here. So okay, so now the cycle is done. It has given us the work. So as you can see, just click here and right click, go to result. So this is 35 kilowatt work. So this is the amount of work you have got from this turbine under this condition. So which, like as I said, you all the value I have put here is hypothetical value. So you need to do your own calculation before putting this in your actual simulation. So that based on your requirement or desired value, you have to put your input, and then you will get the output. All right. Thanks for your time. And in the next webinar, I will be showing the heat exchanger part, like how much energy we can extract from using a heat exchanger. Like this is the amount of energy we are going to discharge, 729. So if you put a heat exchanger here, this is of course a hypothetical value, it will be not like that. But for example, it's a 200 or 300 degree centigrade in the steam, low pressure steam, which you can use for recovery of heat using a heat exchanger. If you just put a heat exchanger here and then pass water or any other substances for this system, then you will be able to collect the energy from here. So that energy you can use for other purposes. So that I will be talking in the later webinar. Until then, it's I would like to take the opportunity to thank you for your time, and hope to see you in the next webinar. Thanks.